Hey, so I just want to show you something which I find intriguing. And I find it intriguing every single day. So right now I'm in Las Vegas. And I'm going to show you something. And every day that I'm here, I notice this same thing happening, right? And I'm intrigued by it because it's to do with marketing. So let me show you what is happening. Okay, so behind me is a McDonald's. I'm sure you recognize that. And so it's around about 5 p.m., so not exactly dinner time. I want to show you the McDonald's. You can see behind me there that there's a couple of cars, maybe four, maybe five cars in the car park, and your regular store, and in the drive-thru, there's no one, all right? We just come through that side there, okay? That's McDonald's at 5 p.m., and there's maybe a handful of people here, okay? And now, so this is Wendy's, all right? And Wendy's also serves burgers. Very much like McDonald's, okay? And so you can see there's one, two, three, four, I think there's five cars in the car park. All right, interesting. All right, now I'm in front of a place called Jack in the Box. All right, you can see there's the car park. That's my car in the background, so it doesn't count. But there's literally two cars around the other side. They serve burgers as well. And they're all in a strip. So I've just literally drove down this street and they're all roughly 100 meters from each other, okay? Three different burger joints, all looking very similar in terms of the car park, in terms of how many people are actually eating in the restaurant. Now, let me show you another burger joint. So now what I'm doing is I'm driving literally another 100 meters to another burger restaurant. And so it's all, they're all in the same area, all in the exact same area. And I want you to notice something very peculiar. At this restaurant, the fourth restaurant, every car you see behind me is a person eating at this restaurant, okay? So this is one car park. And then as we travel further up here, there are cars coming in, of course. But of course, every car I'm about to show you here is somebody dining at this restaurant, okay? So there's cars there, there's cars there. And you'll see cars coming through the drive-through over here. Okay, and then you have cars over here. In fact, as I walk, right, you're seeing more and more cars of people dining at this restaurant. All right, and the car park doesn't end there. So this is the exciting thing for this restaurant, at least, right? As I show you here, every car I'm showing you here, here's another person dining at this restaurant. Okay, very interesting. Isn't it interesting? This is a place called In-N-Out Burger. I'm going to show you that behind me there. In-N-Out Burger. So the difference is that this is a burger restaurant just like any other, okay? In fact, except it's not, all right? So with this one, we have three burger restaurants, all just really close to here, all the same distance apart. And yet this one is full of people wanting to buy their food. The others are struggling. They have bills to pay, staff to pay, leases to pay, and it's the same market, same location, and yet this one is getting the lion's share of the business. Interesting, right? So you've got to ask, and any entrepreneur is going to ask one question: what are they doing differently here than anywhere else? And it's really, really simple, okay? Let me tell you how it works. Any entrepreneur would want to ask the question: what is happening here that is not happening at the other restaurants, okay? Because if you can work that out, then you understand how to market, right? So the difference is that this restaurant has only one burger, right? One burger. McDonald's, as you may already know, has at least 10. The other restaurants I showed you also have around about that same number. They have lots of different drinks, different desserts. And so here has one burger, one size of fries, not small, large, medium, just one size of fries. They have chocolate shake, vanilla shake, strawberry shake, and Coke and lemonade. And that is it. That is the menu. Nothing more, right? All the other restaurants have more. These guys have less. But there's something even more important in that this restaurant has all the food fresh. All right? So for instance, when you order a fries, what happens is they grab a potato, put it through this special cutter. You can see them doing it. You see right into the kitchen. And it spurts it out the other side. All the potato cut into these small little fries. Those are cooked instantly and then served to you. So in around about 90 seconds, 2 minutes, that potato is the actual fries that you're eating. So no frozen material here. The burgers are cooked fresh. The shakes are made from actual ice cream, scooped. All right, and so what happens is they have a marketing advantage. Less stores, less exposure, less marketing budget, and they have an advantage in that they are giving a product which people instantly know is better. It tastes better, it feels better, and it just has that edge which no one else has. It's different. It is absolutely different. It makes it unique. Unique, all right? And what you want to be is the in-and-out burger of your industry. Whether you're a coach, a consultant, any sort of business, to be honest, you need to be the in-and-out burger of your industry. When you've got lots of competition, these folks could easily be sharing that with the rest, and they're not. They could easily have a car park just the same as the rest with hardly any cars there, and no one really wanting their burger. Here, they've got people lining up. What's going to happen is that when it hits 6 o'clock here, it's around about 5:15 now, when it hits 6 o'clock, you'll see people lined up out the store, which is incredible, all right, for a burger store. All right, so this is what you want to be, the in-and-out burger of your industry. Are you going to be able to do it? If so, you have to be completely unique. And when you are unique, it has to make sense to your market. If you can do those two things, suddenly you get the lion's share of the business without actually having to offer anything different with the product. Okay, it all comes down to marketing, as in letting people know your story, letting people know that it is different, and the rest works on its own. All right, hope that helps you out. Here, I'm here at In-N-Out Burger. This is Brett. Talk soon.